Hey everyone, in this 4-minute videos for developers, we're going to see how to prevent denial of service attacks using Spycrest plugin in Edge Microgateway for your APIs. Myself Anil Sagar, I work at Google and Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need Apigee Edge Microgateway installed on your machine and you need an API proxy up and running in your Edge Microgateway, as well as you need to understand how Spycrest works. For that, you can refer earlier 4-minute videos. If you would like to protect your backends against denial of service attacks, then you can able to do that using Spycrest concept. Edge Microgateway provides a Spycrest plugin which is based on Node.js to protect your APIs against denial of service attacks. This Spycrest plugin is completely different from what you have seen in Apigee Edge policy. In Edge Microgateway, instead of policies, you have plugins which are Node.js based. You can able to implement a Spycrest plugin using simple AML configuration inside the Edge Microgateway config file and then protect your APIs against denial of service attacks. Let's see how it works. I'm logged into the machine where my Edge Microgateway is running. Let's go to the configuration file, which is in the root directory and then .hmicro folder. So I have Apigee 4MV4D test config AML. I'm going to edit the AML to change the configuration to implement the Spycrest. Just for the demo, I'm going to turn off the authorization, the OAuth. So I'm going to turn off this, change it to true. And then we are going to implement the Spycrest. To implement the Spycrest, just change the plugin's configuration, add the Spycrest configuration after OAuth. And then we are going to provide the Spycrest rate limits using a simple configuration in the AML file. So I'm going to say Spycrest colon. The first one is time unit. The time unit is a minute. Let's say minute. And then we have to specify the rate limit. We're going to specify the rate limit using allow. So I'm going to allow 12 per minute. So 12 per minute means every 5 seconds we are going to allow only one call. Again, this counter depends on number of worker processes that you are running. By default, it is based on number of CPUs. Since I have only one CPU, then it is exactly 12 per minute. That means every 5 seconds it is going to allow only one call. If you have more than one CPU and Edge Micro instance is running as multiple worker processes, let's say if you have two CPUs, then it will be allowing two calls every 5 seconds. So make sure you verify in the number of CPUs and the number of worker threads that your Micro Gateway instance is running. Let's check it out. Let's start the Edge Micro Gateway instance by using the Edge Micro start command. So Edge Micro start Apigee 4MV4D test and followed by key and secret. Once you start the Edge Micro Gateway, we can able to now test the Spycrest plugin. Let's test the Spycrest plugin by making some calls. Let's make some API calls and test our Spycrest. So I'm going to make some quick calls. So within 5 seconds, I have to make 5 calls. As you can see, the message, Spycrest engaged. So after 5 seconds, then again, it will give you the 200 OK. So if you do the calls within 5 seconds, then you will see finally service unavailable, message Spycrest engaged. So that's how Spycrest policy works in Edge Microgateway. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Please share this video with your colleagues and friends and help spread the knowledge. Subscribe to YouTube channel to get notified of any future videos, and thank you once again.